I'm not oblivious to the questions, to the request, to the plea for me to consider leading the charge and consider running for the Senate. I am considering, but I have yet to make a final decision on whether to run or not to run. While I know we're already midstream of the filing, today is October 4 na.
What is the deadline? August, October 8.
October 8. So, midstream tayo, meron pang natitirang apat na araw. I'm still in the process of consulting well-meaning people, and mapapakinggan ko lang din yung kanilang views and thoughts, and feel whether the Filipino people are already or ready to have a candidate in a campaign minus the, you know, the wherewithals of a national campaign, the logistics, the funding, which incidentally I also discussed during my last meeting with President Duterte. And well, we both agreed na I think if there is really we cannot be oblivious to the request. But let's see, meron pa namang ilang araw na pag-isipang mabuti dahil hindi madaling decision, Wilson. As of this very moment, I'm still 50-50. It's not an easy decision to make.
Yes.
It's not an easy decision to make. This whole thing is eating me. I've been consulting, I've been doing a process of discernment, but I tell you, it's not easy. This again, the only reason why I am considering a run for senator is because I know what is at stake in this midterm election. Even our very own democracy is at stake. But it's up to you. Kung handa na kayo sa ganong uri ng gobyerno, piliin nyo yung administrasyon. Pero kung handa kayong lumaban at lagyan natin ng credible and effective opposition ang both houses of Congress, yung upper house, yung Senado, at yung lower house at ang Kongreso, magtulong-tulong tayo and let's bring in good people there, honest people there who will be championing itong paglaban sa transitioning from presidential to parliamentary at yung sinasabing napipintong impeachment laban kay Vice President Inday Sara Duterte, because that in effect will be disenfranchising the 32 million Filipinos who voted for her. Hindi ho si Sara ang mabibiktima rito pag ito'y hinayaan natin. Si Vice President Inday lamang ang occupant ng posisyon. At ang tunay na biktima dyan ay ang 32 million Filipinos na bumoto kay Vice President Inday Sara. Huwag nating hayaan.